Hi, my name is Roger. In this video, I'm going to show you two ways of saving these two text files. I've made a video a long time ago where I showed you the call function to save a text file. We shouldn't use that any longer, so I'm going to provide you with two possible ways to save your text. The first one is this one. Both have the same text, and we're going to save it into a simple text file. So I'm going to save this one. I'm going to call this one test one. I'm going to save it, and this one will be test two. Test two. So now when I delete this here and this one, let's do the opening test one. As you can see, it reads it perfectly fine in. Test 2, also fine. Why should you use these two? Well, there are more ways, of course, but let me show you the difference in writing. This is the first one. As you can see, it's a huge string. This here is the second one. That's what we want if we want to read it ourselves. So how can you do that, these two different ways? Here we have the interface of the program. These are two text fields, text areas, sorry. And on the left side we have two opening buttons and two save as buttons. That's all we basically have. We have a file type for the text, we have an integer and a folder item declared. So this here is the open dialog here, and I've never mentioned this before. You can do an initial directory. What does that do? It opens a certain directory that you choose over here. If you are on a Linux or Mac computer, you can't have this. You should have something else. So let me get that like this. Now these are all files for all kinds of operating system. Here you have home. When you have home, you should be, I believe, on a Linux machine or operating system. And we also have this one, I believe. Yes, this one, also Linux. On Mac, I don't know. I never worked with a Mac computer, so. But if you copy special folder, go to the help file and paste it in the search bar and press enter, then you can select the one that you need. If you have this, like I have, then you should be on a Microsoft system. Probably it doesn't work on another operating system, so make sure you change that. Now this is a very basic input stream, of course. You all have seen this before. It's a simple text input, open as text, read all, and simply show it on the text area. And then of course close the stream. The second one has the same text, the same code behind it, the same input, nothing's changed. The first save button has only this little bit of code. It has a simple text output stream, and we're gonna create a file. So F, that's a folder item that you are gonna create, and you're simply gonna write into that file whatever is on text area one. It simply writes it to it, like you saw, but it doesn't make any sense. It's a huge string he's gonna write, and of course close the string. Now if you want the second one, the one that is structured, you need this part of the code. This here is the same dialogue, of course, but you want this here. This is the most important part, of course. Here we're gonna create an array. an array of strings. So it can be anything that you wrote in text area 2. You need to split everything that is in text area 2 on this character, character 13. If you are on a new Mac, you should probably use endofline.unix. You can also use endofline on a Microsoft or a Linux machine. You could do that, but character 13 is the enter button of, or the enter key of your keyboard. So that's where you split each line in text area 2. You pass it on to this array, and then you need an output stream, of course. We're going to create F. That's all familiar. You've seen this before. And now we have an array. And in order to write an array to a text file, you have to loop through the array and write each line to your text file. So for I is an integer, is nil to lines.ubound. Ubound means the last element of your array. So it goes from nil to the very last one. Then save text dot write line, and then lines I. I stands for each element in that particular array. And then you close the stream and you are good to go. So hopefully it helped anyone, and hopefully we meet in the next video.